All right, fuckers and fuckettes, now, I have no reason, in fact, I have a beef with them. And some of you who have watched some of my other videos know why I have a beef with them. I'm not going to get into that. But Homeland Insecurity and TSA, there is a reason that they seize some of your devices. And I'm not going to say that I am that reason, but I will say that people like me are. People with my capabilities are. And there's people with a lot greater capabilities than what I am, what I have available to me. The reason that they seize some of your devices is simple. You have people like me out there who make things like this. This looks like a normal Earthmate GPS, doesn't it? I guarantee you, if I walk up to your laptop computer or the laptop computer of your choice, and I plug this in right now, it is. I also guarantee you that if I push in with a paperclip, it has to be a metal one, on that little LED, and cross back here at the same time, not only has what appears to be an LED turned into a camera, it's got an effective omnidirectional audio range with background clarification. It eliminates background noise, basically, for most vehicles. Right there. All right, what else? And it does load the drivers for both those devices at the time that I cross the back two screws. But I do have to have the LED pushed in at the same time for the simple reason that, guess what? That's the switch, a little micro switch under there. Now, I've also built these to where they don't have to be plugged into a computer. I've built them with watch batteries and gutted apart 16 and even as recent as 64 gig SD cards and MP3 players with recording capabilities, and just had, there's enough room to stash them in there. And usually if I do one of those, it's just a simple microphone because that circuit's kind of crude, elementary. And even though I have wave soldering tables, it's just much easier to, you got a goddamn GTAC in your car anyway. Look, plug this in. Most people don't know that your goddamn GPS is built into your computer. Get them talking. You know, leave it hanging up from your mirror. Do what you got to do. That's not my problem. All I can do is build a device for you that looks like it's normal. And no, I will not build these devices for you. Unless you're somebody I formerly worked with, or someone who I know for an absolute fact has reason to have one of these devices, I will not do it for you. I will not even consider it. I may consider telling you, you know, Joey over there might do it for you. You might want to ask me about the background on Joey. I ain't gonna tell you unless you ask. Devices like this. Looks like a normal marine radio. You'd see it on any boat, right? Pretty nice one, too. You can mount it in dash or you can mount it on a bracket. I made this for a buddy of mine. It was in a situation where he needed to be able to phone for backup. But he couldn't have his cell phone with him. And if he did need backup, he needed that Marine Patrol there right as fucking fast as they could get there. But he also needed it low power enough to where if he was next to another vessel, he wouldn't be bleeding over on them. Now there is a corresponding antenna for this, and the SWRs are way the fuck off on the Marine band, but they're perfect for the cop band, which is where he needed to be. You turn this on, it is a normal Marine radio. You hold these two buttons as you're turning it on, and it's a cop band radio, very low power. There was more than enough room to hide that in there. There was more than enough room to hide a couple of surface mount relays in there to switch it over from one to the other. And he only needed one channel, so it was really simple. Now, I won't help a cop bust anybody, but when it's a friend of mine that I know by proxy through family members that is in a situation like that, as long as he doesn't tell me what specifically he's doing with it, and I like him enough to where I figure, yeah, okay, that's one cop that I don't want to die, which in that case means that I know that that is one cop that from the time he picked that badge up until the time he puts it down for good, he's going to do, he has been and is going to do his absolute best to uphold the laws, to obey the laws he's sworn to uphold. Them other kind, I won't help for shit. Them kind that knowingly and willingly break the law, no, I won't help them for shit. So there's very few regular deputies or state patrol that I will help at all. And if I didn't know that he's a square shooter, I would not have built this for him. And it's going back to him sometime in the next few days. It's just here for illustration purposes. That's another reason why TSA / Homeland Insecurity likes to steal your devices. And yes, I intentionally pushed the wrong two buttons. I'm willing to illustrate to you how it works, but not how exactly. And I'm honest enough to tell you that I did that. But I did narrow it down to two buttons for you. So if you happen to see it on his boat, chances are he's not using it anymore, or he's already got something better. And there's another one. Now, let's get into common devices. Pretty old, ain't it? This one's fairly new. In fact, I can program your SIM cards on this one. I don't mean just read them. Some of these devices we know that I purchased compromised from other videos. These are here for illustrative purposes. I'm merely explaining why TSA and Homeland Insecurity are interested or have interest in seizing electronics from people. It very probably is not because they suspected you directly. It's very probably because these are common tricks. These are off-the-shelf tricks that people brag about, and they've been bragging about them long enough that TSA and Homeland Insecurity is aware of them. Some of them are tricks that DOD used to use long time ago. I hope to God they've quit doing this shit. And I broke out one of these just for specific illustration. Let me find that. And I'll actually get a little bit detailed on this. All right, right here. Okay. So if I go through an airport and I've got one of these in my pocket, and bear in mind, Homeland Insecurity and TSA, they have not busted any terrorists. So they're out to get you for anything they can, if they can. Well, if I go through an airport with one of these in my pocket, There are too many of these out there that have been modified, not by me, to where they'll broadcast more than legal power. Now, what I mean by more than legal power is, yes, you may be using the software that came with it and setting it on 100% power for the US zone. And again, I'm oversimplifying. So you may be staying under the 1 watt maximum total system legal Wi-Fi power. But say I put a booster antenna on this, and my EIRP, my emitted or radiated power, becomes more than what 1 watt is capable of because of either a coil load in the antenna or whatever, or because it's just that good of an antenna. If I put a 24 dB antenna on this and run it at half power, I am radiating more power than is legal. I'm also radiating more power than is safe to humans or small animals. At 30 dB, I can chase cockroaches with this. I can only do it for about 5-6 feet, but they will stay the hell away from it. And I don't mean that I'm out there chasing them. I mean, I'll leave it sitting there. I'll leave fucking piece of rotted apple or banana out there. I'll let them get up there, get eaten good, and then I'll kick it on and watch them fucking run, just like you kicked the lights on when they were crawling over your counter in the middle of the night. You only think I'm kidding. They're... And granted, like I said, that's only at very short range. So, I mean, if somebody had that up on a tower, it probably wouldn't hurt anything. But there's two standards. There's the power output of your transmitter plus your radiated power. And you may not be enough to bother with if they seize your device and you've illegally modified it. Yeah, chances are you truly are not ever getting it back. Because the device itself is illegal, but they won't tell you that. Because they don't want to go through the paperwork and they don't want to, okay, you're in violation of Title 19 United States Code section. I'm not going to go into that, but I can. And by the way, this one is an Orinoco inside. But I was sloppy, and that's another thing. Stuff like that. That's a dead giveaway that it's been modified. And no, I haven't really modified the actual device. So what I said earlier is accurate. I'm just using another device's case. You get the idea. And I'm way under legal radiated power with this thing. This is out here for illustration purposes only. Well, let me show you something else here. Devices like this. Now, these are a little bit harder to modify. They're trained to look for that seal to be broken. Why are they trained to look for that seal to be broken? Well, back in the dark days of when card readers were running on parallel and USB 1.0 was still in draft, DOD, CIA, I don't think Justice ever had any of them, used to build things in. There is no way that this particular PCMCIA adapter should be able to read an 8 gig card, but it does, because it has been modified. There's Wi-Fi transmission capabilities in here. There's a script in here that is trained to read every other drive in the machine. The minute the drivers for this device are, you don't even have to load the drivers. Once you power on the machine, it has its own. It doesn't need them. that would store everything. But back in the parallel days, this was really fancy. And if I had one that was 64 megs to work with, it was a miracle. Well, they used to use these to sneak information, data, in and out of other countries. That's why these types of devices are suspect. Because it's projectionism, basically. You know, they think in the back of their mind, well, that's what I'd do and that's what I'd use. That's what I've been trained that we used to use. Shit, that's suspect. So they're projecting their mentality upon you, even though you may have a perfectly legitimate device. Now the rest of these devices, like I say, you know that I got some of them already modified. So anything I say from this point on is pretty much for illustrative purposes. These are one of my favorite tricks. I love these D-Link cases like this because they're quick and easy. And the problem that you have to overcome hiding one of these, and they will plug them in on you these days, so this trick has kind of been burned. But say you've got your notebook along and you've got one of these along. Look at how easy it is to pop that fucker apart. It's every bit as easy to put it right back together. Now, why did I show you that? You know these little SanDisk sliders? Like that. You know that circuit fits perfectly in there, and the average person would not know it. Do you know that that is how China got a lot of information out of the United States? That is how North Korea has been getting a lot of information out of the United States? Now granted, TSA has caught no terrorists. But that's why they suspect such a device. Now there is a whole list of devices that are just automatically suspect. Especially USB devices with loose connectors. Oh, fuck, I bent that guy. Oh, no, I got it upside down. Yeah, that's better. And like I say, this is just for illustrative purposes. We do know that some of these devices have indeed been modified before I ever got them. And I got them because it's an area of interest for me. Not because I will ever use them externally against anyone. It's just curiosity. Wow, how did they make that work? Devices like this. Simple USB hub, correct? Now, do you know how ridiculously easy? You know how much room you've got in there? You got plenty of room. Either for data storage, Wi-Fi transceiver, whatever you want. And it's ridiculously easy because this device does not actually need external power. It's ridiculously easy to cut the traces on the board, and where your power would normally come in here, take your damn wall wart apart and just short cut the wires off inside the wall wart, short them across, and there's you a switch to switch it back and forth from one to the other, and all you need is a couple of little surface mount relays. And you can switch back and forth to any device you want. Why? Because USB only uses two DAC lines. DPDT relay. It only uses two power lines. DPDT relay if you truly need it. You shouldn't. And you should just be able to switch the DAC lines. Same with these. And devices like this also automatically suspect. And I've got a CMAP one with a clear case. Now the reason that I bought the CMAP card reader with the clear case is if I ever am unfortunate enough to have to fly commercial, I don't want it taken from me, so I leave the circuit open and exposed. And that clear case shows them that it's open and exposed. But now that CMAP or an avionics card reader, they basically know on that CMAP reader what the circuit is supposed to look like. There are people a lot better than me. I've seen some of those CMAP card readers. You see, Navionics and CMAP card readers have an extra chip in them that I'm not going to tell you how to decrypt your map cards, but that chip can be replaced. That chip can also be piggybacked. Get the idea? Again, automatically suspect. Now let's get to this one. The pièce de résistance. Actually, I'm full of shit. It's not. This one is. This one's got plenty of room. I mean, literally, I could put in a microcomputer based on the same processor as your average cell phone running on Linux and have a full-blown little computer in there with Wi-Fi transceive capabilities, and the average person is not going to see, you know, because it's not going to broadcast any SSID. The average person is not going to know that by plugging this in, I can read every single thing on their machine. These were really common leeching devices. That's why they're suspect. If they seize your notebook, again, they know what should be in the bottom of the notebook. Now, I know a lot of people with notebook computers that they've had, you know, oh man, the fucking stock Wi-Fi on this son of a bitch sucks. They take it to their local computer guy, they take it to the Geek Squad, whoever, and you know, they put in a Cisco ABG, you know, mini PCI card, UFL connectors, UFL connector, and driver's a driver. You can actually put anything you want in that mini PCI slot. I've got Tesla units that are mini PCI, and I don't mean Tesla coils, I mean NVIDIA Tesla stuff, GPUs. And those are right off the fucking shelf. They're a little bit pricey. You might not want to go out and, unless you can find one used, they're really not affordable. Unless you happen to be the government. Now, devices like this one, where you've got a pair of LEDs instead of just one. And by the way, those cards that I mentioned earlier, those thin ones that we used to use back in the parallel days when USB was still in draft, well, this one will still read those and write them. Well, you notice how those two little LEDs are recessed in there. There's a reason for that. Don't know what it is, but I know that my reason is because one of them actually is a micro switch. It will still light up because I'm a slick bastard like that. But if I push it in, I'm only going to explain this in theory. You can find these readily available. They're little adapters to where you put your micro SD card in. Well, internally, say that it has one. Or say that it even has one of these piggybacked in there. Okay, if it has one of these piggybacked in there, they're going to know it. They're not likely to take the device apart. But if they plug it in and they see that it shows up as a card reader with an active drive, that's going to draw suspicion. Do they have the right to plug it in? Yeah, they've got some kind of an order going on right now. If you live within 100 miles of any United States border, they can take your electronics, your phone, your computer, your cards, anything. Oh yeah, and back on the notebooks a little bit. If you've had that little Wi-Fi card replaced and their list says, oh, it's supposed to have this, it's got that, well, that's suspect. Because these are the tricks that the government used to pull years ago. These are the tricks that have been bragged about in the forums. Oh yeah, man, I rigged a mini PCI into an SSD, solid state drive. I got 32 gigs of storage right there on a little mini PCI card, 64 gigs. Yeah, they've been hip to that for a while. But that is how a lot of information has been passed in and out of the United States, both by our government and by foreign governments. That's been going on for years. So by them suspecting that device, it's not your fault. It's not their fault. They're doing their job. They're doing what they're being paid to do. You know, they spot something like that. It is their job to pass it on to somebody who gets paid more than they do. Well, that somebody that gets paid more than they do may not be the brightest bulb on the tree. I mean, they've got some very sharp motherfuckers working for them and with them. I refuse to be one of them. I actually despise Homeland Insecurity / TSA, and like I said, I have no reason to defend them. And I'm not defending them. I'm just explaining why a lot of your stuff, a lot of your electronics are getting taken as you go through airports, and you're probably not getting them back in any reasonable period of time. And you better believe when you go through an airport these days, they know everything that your body is transmitting. That's why, you know, when people rig devices like these, they rig in little micro switches. And if you see chew marks on my shit, well, that's because I've got squirrels in the house. And they got a hold of it. And like I say, I mean, these devices here are just for illustration. I'm illustrating how easy it is. And I'm illustrating how common it is. Yeah, you as Americans, you know, I fully understand that TSA has caught no terrorists the entire time that they've existed. I fully despise the fact that they're groping six-year-olds, they're fucking emailing each other and their friends body scanner pictures of hot chicks or hot dudes. There's a lot of women in TSA that seem to be more perverted than the men. Weird. Well, actually, that's a good thing. I like a good female pervert, me. Device like this. You see that blue lens on there? Well, blue is actually a desirable color for a lens. Not this particular shade of blue. But it's actually a desirable color for a lens that looks down through the water and reduces glare. It's actually a desirable color for an underwater lens. That little stupid piece of plastic that's an LED. You seen these $9 pinhole cameras on pick your favorite Metro Spy Supply, whatever fucking website you want. eBay, for God's sakes. Amazon. It's that easy to get this shit. You know how easy it is to hide one of those little pinhole cameras in there? You know how easy it is to replicate that silkscreen and put a real lens on there? And still have the light when you plug the sumbitch in and it's reading a drive? Ooh, you didn't think about that, did you? Well, other people have. That's why your devices are suspect. Duh. And it's unfortunate that we as Americans have to deal with that level of paranoia on the part of our government. I think mostly they're trying to scare the general public. When in reality, if they had anything valid, we'd have seen a bunch of terrorists being locked up or already on death row by now. And meanwhile, we've got 36 Islamic terrorist camps right here in the United States right now. We have foreign military bases in northern Mexico right now with weapons aimed at the United States. It's not me being an asshole, that's the God's honest truth. I am not a conspiracy theorist. I would not say that if I hadn't spent some time playing around with Russia's equivalent of Google Earth and verifying it for myself. Because quite frankly, as long as Google's sharing information with our federal government, I love them to death. I use them every day. But chances are you're not seeing any personal information of mine on the internet. If you do see me buy something on the internet, I'm going down to Target. Well, first I'm going to the bank, taking out a little cash, then I'm going to Target, getting me a fucking prepaid credit card, going online and ordering the some bitch. You know, that way if I do lose something, be it to a hacker or whatever, I haven't lost as much as if they'd got my real card. And I don't have the hassles as if they'd got my real card. You know, you don't have that, you're in Walmart and they tell you, well, your card's been compromised. Oh, fuck. You know, you don't need that shit on the internet when you're trying to order a part in Overnight Express and you need it the next fucking day. Get the idea? Remember a couple of years ago when they rigged the flash drives on the voting machines to where it was actually a virus, to where when you plug in the flash, it would modify the code slightly and you could pretty much rig an election in your favor. And I'm not too sure that Diebold's fixed that, Diebold, whatever you want to call them. Well, cards such as this one, and this one has been modified, I've already had it apart. I look for that Write Protect tab if I'm selecting one. You see, like, these don't have a Write Protect tab. They're basically useless unless you're willing to take them apart. And they are far less suspect, though. They're not as likely to get seized. They probably are now because I just publicly mentioned that, yeah, it's not that big of a deal to modify them. It's a pain in the ass. Very time consuming. These are easy. These are quick. As are these. There's micro Wi-Fi available right now that'll fit in there. And still reach your card. You can fit the chips from an entire second card in there and create a pseudo RAID area inside. There's enough room to do that physically. Why would you do that? Well, let's see. You can be leaching data to a second drive, so they pull out your mini, you check it. You can rig it to where the only thing that can be wiped is your mini. You can do all sorts of wonderful things. Well, that's why these are suspect. And I have in the past had one of these micro SD cards or adapters. This one doesn't come apart. Fuck, I grabbed the wrong goddamn one. Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. This is one of the ones where you gotta fucking heat it to get it back together, though. And it's really easy to rig that Write Protect switch to do any damn thing you want, trip or relay, whatever the fuck you want. Hide the fact that you've got another device in there, hide the fact that the second you plug it in, it's gonna infect a machine, or the second you plug it in, it's gonna install a program that's going to phone home to Nezra. Get the idea? Yeah. These codecs, same deal. Some of the pennies, the PNYs are really hard to take apart. They're not as likely to be suspect. The codecs are ridiculously easy. The earlier codecs, I should be more specific. So if you're going to go through an airport with an SD card, make sure it's clear, because they do have a diagram of the circuits And that makes it a lot more likely that you'll get it back in a reasonable period of time. Now you notice I didn't say that you won't get it back. And I did throw that caveat in there, in a reasonable time. Now I know that there are minds out there watching this that are more advanced than I am. And I have done my absolute best to put this down into plain English to where the average person can understand. So we're going to give it the ultimate test right now, because I have not only a Yankee, she's a blonde too, sitting right here. Did you understand most of what I said?
Yeah.
Did I make it clear enough that I was illustrating?
Yes, you did.
And that the intent was illustrative?
Yes.
Thank you. One more device. These little things. Your earpiece. I've heard, seen people whining about they lost their earpiece going through the airport. But you know what? These already have a Bluetooth transceiver in them. And think about it. If that little mic hidden behind that port there is able to pick up you talking, how easy is it to turn the gain up? Maybe put in a filter and make it to where the entire room can be heard instead of just you. It's pretty fucking easy. How easy is it? A little bit dangerous on your head. I mean, that's kind of into a band that you really don't want transmitting with any kind of power on your head. But how easy is it to turn that Bluetooth transceiver into a partial high-powered transmitter? Still a transceiver, still talking perfectly to your phone, still working correctly. But able to be used as a listening device if you're, say, in a conference room or something like that, and need that conversation to punch through a wall. Guess what? There you go. It's almost a ready-made device. That's why they're suspect. Now, as I think I stated earlier, when you walk through today's airports, which are infested by TSA, and my reason for not wanting to fly, you know, even if I was taken off the no-fly list today, my reason for not wanting to fly is I've seen these TSA pat-downs. My little squirrel can jump on my back. I'm fucked up for a couple of days. But if he hits me wrong, or if I'm already hurting, I can, you know, people pat me on the back, I'm pretty much screwed. But under normal circumstances, TSA ain't too light with people. So that reason alone would prevent me from going through anything. Plus, I mean, I got three slugs in my spine. I'm going to trip the fucking metal detectors right there, even if I'm naked. Yeah, so that's going to be suspect. Then you're going to get a body scan or a cavity scan, whether you want it or not. You know, I'm sorry, I'm not willing to put up with that. I'm American to the core. I will do anything I can to make sure America stays America and no foreign government takes over, whatever the hell. I hope that doesn't happen in my lifetime. I truly do. But at the same time, I'm not willing to put up with that, ever. And I stressed at the beginning, I have no reason to defend TSA or Homeland Insecurity. I hate them with a passion for what they did. That's been discussed in another video. I will not discuss it here. I'm only clarifying why the average person's electronics are suspect and likely to get seized and not returned in a reasonable amount of time. And I did explain why sometimes some devices accidentally, on purpose, get not returned. It's not really because the end user did anything wrong. It's not really because their intent is wrong. In the case of the notebook with the modified Wi-Fi card, which I failed to elaborate on, I know this because I'm thinking in the back of my mind this whole time, how do I make this fucking simple enough that Joe Schmo can understand it? How do I make this simple enough to where the average kid can understand it? But do you really want to do 5 years for having a booster antenna on a 1-watt fucking device, or a legal power, what would otherwise be a legal power device? No, you don't. So if they keep that on you, or if they keep your notebook with the modified with the high-powered Wi-Fi on you, perhaps there is a percentage of the time when they have reason. Perhaps there is a percentage of the time when they're being assholes. You know, you've gotten all pissy with them and pissed them off in the process. And yeah, you know, they're human. They're going to be assholes sometimes. I think those two scenarios to be a very, very, if I think them to be a fractional percentage, a part of less than 1% of the cases. It may be because I choose to believe that. It may be because I choose to believe that our government is a little bit more honest than they are, a little bit less corrupt than they are. But really, if you've got that high-powered Wi-Fi, which with its own factory antenna is legal and lawful, running at even 100% power. But you've got an antenna that puts it over the maximum legal radiated power, and they kept it from you. They just chucked it in the trash. They weren't being assholes at all. They did you a fucking favor and kept your ass out of prison and just don't want to tell you that that's what happened. If they keep that notebook with the highly modified Wi-Fi, or just the high-powered Wi-Fi card popped in there, to where the stock antenna was probably boosting some weak, cheap-ass Wi-Fi card, and you put in a good Wi-Fi card and brought the thing over the legal limit, guess what? They actually did you a favor keeping that thing. Title 19 is not very clear on knowingly and or willingly. I promise you that. Now, if you go through an airport and you have war driving software and a high-powered card in your notebook and they keep it, that's your own fucking bad. And if you're war driving and breaking into networks that you're not supposed to, well, hey, you know what? You deserve whatever the fuck you get. I wish they'd put you in jail instead of just taking your shit and failing to return it. But I believe the majority of cases where people don't get it back are because they really just don't want to do the paperwork, and they'd rather not put Joe Schmo Citizen in prison for something that Joe Schmo Citizen doesn't realize that he or she did wrong. They'd really rather just destroy the throw the device in the fucking trash and, yeah, oh, no, we lost it. Sorry about that. Because it's a lot cheaper to buy you a new device eventually than it is to keep your ass in prison. And quite frankly, our government is not only broke, they're way deep in debt. They don't have the prison space even if they had the money to keep you. Now, I hope truly that I've made that simple enough for folks to understand. I hope truly that I've made that to where people can comprehend that a lot of what's being said, you need to weigh with a grain of salt, because a lot of what is happening out there, you know, on the internet and in these blogs and shit, oh man, I went through there. You know, I'd be pissed if they kept my fucking lighter. I really would. And even if it's a 50-cent lighter, I paid that 50 cents. Give me my 50 cents, you won't keep the son of a bitch. That's how I feel about it. But, yep. Quit yawning over there. Get up here.
Are you done?
Pretty close. I've been trying to taper off for a minute because I have two or three other things that I would like to mention, but I can't figure out how to mention them without getting myself an obstruction of justice charge. There are other devices that I would just recommend you didn't even have in your carry-on luggage, because they're highly suspect, and they're so close to devices that could be used against Americans. I don't give a fuck if they're used against people from other countries. Well, okay, maybe Canada. I got a few friends in Mexico. I wouldn't want to see nothing happen to them. But I can't figure out that how to bring those out here without I can't figure out how to bring those out here with verbally without crossing the line. I've got to do some reading on that. So we'll holler at y'all fuckers and fuckheads later. I hope I made this simple enough for everybody.